Okay, so we are live.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
So,
How are you?
good evening to both of you. And I have to start by saying thank you, big thank yous for being here. Both of you have, in this whatever last odd decade of me knowing you, I also understand that you've been really, really busy, and I know how tough it has been for you guys to take out time for this. But thank you so much. And I would like to start on this note that we recently, did celebrate the Women's Day, but both of you here are definitely examples of how it's celebrated each day. And more to that, of course, will come when, the audience, our viewers actually know what you do. So we'll start with you, Komal. Why don't you share a little about yourself?
About myself. So currently I run an events company and I'm a mom of a 10-year-old. I am a computer engineer by profession, and I've also worked in coding and all. But when my daughter was around 3, I took a call to start this company. So we do all sorts of social events. And so, I love doing what I do, and I spend a lot of time with my daughter as well. That's about it.
Great. What she's definitely she's somebody who can create miracles out of scratch, and she's very, very creative. And this is how I know her, even professionally and personally. So thank you so much for being here, Komal, and welcome.
Thank you so much.
Moving.
I'm so happy to be here.
Great. Thank you. Same here. So Preeti, please tell us something about yourself.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. Okay, first of all, thank you so much, Khushbu, I think, inviting me over here. I think it's such a great platform for new parents who are looking forward. And I'm so, so grateful. I've been knowing you for like about a decade now. And this is the absolute great platform. I must say this. Okay, moving on towards me. What I do is I'm a makeup artist by profession. I actually beautify. I mean, like I enhance people beautiful features, basically. And I'm a mother of twins, a boy and a girl. And I it's such a great feeling to be with them and working. And I just love what I do. And that's about it.
Right. And I think again, with how it is when these great people become so humble, Preeti is also missing out on a little more information, which is that she had a stint with education too, right? You were also an educator.
I had been an educator for about 3 to 4 years, maybe. Yeah. So that is when I met you.
Yes. That is when we met, and I think after that, from being an educator, your journey was to be a mother, and then now you're transforming people beautifully, right?
Mother, and then now. Yeah, that's the gist of it. Yes, of course.
Right. So for the viewers, why we are here today is because one very important aspect of being parents is when you're looking out for a school for your child. And as much as it might just sound very easy, it might just come very easy to certain parents. In the recent few years, with the kind of options that we have around, with the kind of knowledge that we have, the decision is becoming tougher. And when we say tough, it is not tough in the aspects of just going and finding the school and just getting the admission. It is about every parent wants the best. So defining and deciphering what is this best is what makes this decision really tough. EduStoke steps in here, and we provide the valuable, genuine information to the parents that they would need while making this decision. So Komal, your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I think this platform is really great, and I really wish it was around when I was school hunting back 10 years, maybe 7 years ago. But yes, I've done so many school changing and so much research while I was getting my daughter admitted. So I've changed 3 schools till now. But finally, it has settled in, and you know, I'm happy now. So definitely, you know, finding, I think, you know, more than the school, I think you have to see, every school has its pros and cons, right? So you really need to see what works for you, for your child. And as parents also, you know, we want, like, maybe somebody feel, you know, some parent wants their child to just, you know, have an overall exposure,
right?
Somebody maybe wants, you know, more involvement, you know. Somebody is okay, yaar, achha, you know, I've heard parents saying ki are school mein na mera bachcha bada confident hai to speak, okay, on stage without any fear. So it really depends as a parent what you want your child to achieve. Some parents, they just want their children to be happy. Because the bachcha khush hai na, so that's more than enough for me, you know. But as a parent, like me and my husband, for us it was very important that firstly, my daughter, she was happy to learn, and whatever she's learning, she's you know, having a, you know, for me it was not sufficient that you know, that she would go and learn something from school, and then when I prod her at a different level, she's clueless, you know. So this is something me and my husband were very particular about, that whatever you do, you should do it properly, otherwise there's no point in doing it, you know. So this was one of the main things that we were looking at when we were looking for school, and the school overall, you know, how involved they are in ensuring the child learns the concepts clearly. That is very important,
right,
for us as parents.
Right. Preeti, your thoughts on...
Yeah, I mean, I think EduStock is one of the great platforms. Like, you know, now newbie parents were really looking forward for the schoolings, and who are, you know, that's a very overwhelming yet very joyous, you know, decision right now. Like, you know, the finding a school, and I've gone through that, and you know, EduStock, I think you guys are doing such a great work helping out newbie parents. And I have, you know, I've really recommended this platform to so many of the parents who are really looking forward. So I think for you guys, I'm really, that's such a commendable work you guys are doing. I'm so happy about it. And I think nothing greater than anything, you know, if somebody is doing your job, you know, simplifying the job, not doing the job, but I think simplifying the job, that's the right, correct thing. So I think that is, you guys are really, I think I feel really proud to say that, you know, I'm in contact with you guys.
Great. Thank you.
I'd also like to add, Khushboo, that, you know, the whole, I mean, you know, for other parents who's watching this, you know, they're talking to mums already whose children are going to school. You know, you're giving that platform, that itself speaks volumes, you know, that you're able to let parents connect with fellow parents, you know, because I remember when I, you know, we had social groups in which we asked recommendations from people, but giving one, you know, that one-to-one experience from a parent, you know, that, yeah, this, you know, this is a good school, you know, something like that, that really helps for parents to take it.
That is absolutely, I agree with Komal on this. Like, you know, this, you know, simplifying our job is like, you know, finding a good school, like in which grounds, I think we don't understand the technicality behind it. I guess you guys do it. So I think that's really nice of you people who are doing this job. Yeah.
Great, great. So, Komal, I'm coming back to when you spoke about your journey when you started looking at the school, and you were clear in your mind that you're looking at a school that is where you just don't get the concept, but you know what the concept is, and they just don't teach you one topic, but they teach you how it is done. So, how important was the curriculum, when you were looking at the school, the consideration of the choice of curriculum?
See, before, I used to be of this mindset that curriculum does not matter. It's all about how you go about teaching and how the child is learning. Okay. But over a period of time, after doing so many school hopping, I've realized no, curriculum has a big role to play in. And, the whole concept of little things like taking ownership of your work, being responsible for your work, even little things like not being behind your children's back, ki homework karo, ye karo. My daughter is only 10, okay, and yet she has a very strong sense of ownership and responsibility. I don't need to tell her ever ki go and do your homework. Okay, I don't need to sit with her and do her research work or whatever projects that she's working on. I don't need to sit and do all that with her, because that is imbibed in the child because the curriculum is such.
Yes.
But if the curriculum is that kind in which they tell ki na you should do it this way, abhi ye rote karo, this kind of curriculum, then the child doesn't even know why they're doing it. First of all, child should know, why are they doing something? What is the purpose of it? Only then they are motivated to do something. If they do not know and they're just, and today's children, they don't take instructions without reasoning. You give them instruction, you have to give them a logical reasoning behind it. If you're just going to tell them, "Acha, you do this now," okay? Why should I do it? That's the first question. Why should I do it? And I feel this. Over a period of time, it will really help them in decision making, have more clarity in thought on what they want to become. When we were kids, did we even know what we wanted to become? Our parents just told us, "अरे डॉक्टर बनना है, इंजीनियर बनना है, बनना है बस वही बनना है, दैट्स इट." बट वाई बनना है यार, आई डोंट वांट टू बिकम डॉक्टर, प्रोबेबली आई हैव सम अदर इंटरेस्ट इन लाइफ, सो बट आई वाज नॉट एबल टू थिंक क्लियरली बिकॉज वी वर नॉट गिवन दैट काइंड ऑफ एक्सपोजर. But in today's times, we have really nice schools, very progressive schools that allows your children to think on their feet, and at this tender age when they're able to make decisions on their own, I think they are on the right path.
Preeti, your take now that the new age parents, as you said, would be looking out, what should they keep in mind when curriculum is considered?
See, as for my personal choice, I would speak on that. I totally agree with Komal what she said, and curriculum does play a really important role. But I think I will differ a little bit on that point when Komal said curriculum plays a very important role. We used to think like that way. I, as of now, I am on the same mentality right now with Komal, right? Because I am a very new parent. So I, for me right now, curriculum is not that important so much right now. Of course, curriculum is important. Individually, it is really important. But yes, of course, right now, I think the culture of the school is really important. I feel what all things are they going to imbibe my parent, my child? What all extracurricular activities are they going to participate? Get into participate my kid into, and what really good mindset for me, basically moral values, good mindset, independency, these all things come really important to me. Then of course curriculum goes hand in hand, obviously when I'll go in junior school or maybe senior secondary, obviously I will also think on that grounds, also. But of course, when they are very on a very tender age, I want them to be,
The culture, you're seeing what matters.
So I want very independency on the curriculum. I don't want to be like, सी कोमल, कोमल सेड अ वेरी राइट थिंग. यू नो हम लोग जब छोटे होते थे हम लोगों को पेरेंट्स ने यही बोला था कि अच्छा यार अब तुम लोगों को टीचर बनना है, तुम लोगों को डॉक्टर बनना है, तुम लोगों को इंजीनियर बनना है. बट राइट नाउ द स्कूल्स हैव सो सच वास्ट यू नो दे कैन अमेंड द करिकुलम एज पर योर चॉइस. आई थिंक दोज थिंग. So I think culture is the main important thing right now as of as for the new age parents.
Right.
That is what I really feel and I really vouch on it. Because if I see that, you know, that curriculum, agar aapko machine hi banana hai apne bachche ko, to fir fayda kya hai yaar itna itna acha curriculum dalne ka bhi tum logon ko. Agar bachcha apne 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 dimag apne mind se independency se if she or he cannot think only, then what is the point of you know imbibing so many things? Ab machine ki tarah likhte jana hai, padhte jana hai, kya fayda is cheez ka? I feel that way.
Right. But to add to your point, Preeti, that's yeah. what I'm saying. Since you're you know you're a new parent, like you said, you know, so probably now these things matter a lot. But
yeah,
in the you know, eventually when your child's these concepts, the culture, the mindset and everything yeah. is actually yeah. a part of the curriculum. Okay.
Curriculum.
If your curriculum is good, these things are taken care of, you know?
Curriculum
eventually will play an important role.
This is what I said in the first thing only. Curriculum is really yeah. important, I know. That is obviously yeah. there. But yeah. I think culture of the school is also plays a very great role in the this thing. Yeah.
Uma, you mentioned that you know you of course did you know change a couple of schools, but tell me something. Did interacting with the school staff at any given point help? You know your decision, was it a catalyst when you went to the school and you met you know the staff, or supposedly in a phase like today, you know, if I talk in context of parents who might be virtually wanting to, you know, meet the school or see the school, do you think that helps?
Yeah, I do feel it helps, because you know when I finally went to the last school seeking for admission, so you know how it works in schools is that they have this marketing phase, right? Who will give you all the jargons, marketing jargons, ki hamara school aisa hai, waisa hai. So I've already done the drill, right? Twice before. So I told them ki yaar mujhe na marketing bande se baat hi nahi karna, please take me to the classroom. You know, I really want to go and check out the classroom. I want to speak to the teachers. I want to interact with the children. I want to actually look at their notebooks and see what they're doing, you know, and they were really open to do that, you know. They let me go, they let me see all the things, and only after doing all that I took a call and I felt, you know, this is a good fit for my child, you know, because most schools, you know, they're the talking, the face, the point of contact, you know, they I think they're all trained in one particular manner to, you know, talk about the school. But then once your child is in the school, then you realize that that was just a facade. And अंदर कुछ और ही हो रहा है, you know.
Right.
So yes, interacting with teachers, with fellow parents also whose children go to the same school, with the children themselves. I think children, you know, when you interact with the children, they I think they are the most honest people, yeah. you know, to talk to. So they you know, and the way they communicate, the way they talk, you know, that itself tells a lot.
Right,
about the school.
Preeti, what's your take on this? What did meeting or
I totally
the school stuff
yeah.
you know change your mindset?
Yeah, of course. I totally agree with Komal what she said right now. I'm with you, Komal, because staff actually they are, you know, they represent your brand, whatever school or whatever, you know, anything I'm saying. So staff really represent. So if I am meeting a teacher or any staff in the school, of course I will judge the school according to that grounds only.
Right.
If I am connected to you, so is my child.
Right.
So this is really important for me. I will judge. I of course there is no buts, no ifs and buts in that question. of course, the teachers are the face of any school or any brand. So if I have the right mindset, I have the connectivity with the teacher, of course my child will be will be connected to you. As actually one of my twin son, my son is basically a little shy, and so he takes time to open up. So for me, it is really important so that he gets really, he gets connected to the teacher he is with. So this is really important for me. So there is no such thing like I will not judge the school without, meeting any teacher. So I would want to meet a teacher if I am looking forward for a school.
Right. Komal, I'm coming to this one very critical aspect now. Parents often come and they're questioning one about the distance, and secondly, they talk about the building and the facade. How important are these things when you're looking out for the school?
See, distance, I do feel it is important. If my child is going to school, I think the less they are on the road, especially in India, where there's so many uncertainties on the road, कभी भी strike हो जाता है, कभी भी protest हो जाता है, कुछ भी हो जाता है. So I think distance is important. The closer they are to home, it's easier. Something happens, you can just go to the school and pick your child up, and they're spending less time in the traffic and on the road, and they're not too tired when they come home or when they reach school, right? So I feel that it is always, it makes sense to find a school that's close to your home. And in terms of infrastructure also, there are so many schools that have really, really very good infrastructure, where they even teach horse riding, archery, and bahut kuch hota hai.
Right.
Really, that is not my priority. The main should be your learning. Okay, baki cheeze to co-curricular. See, every child, they will always excel in maybe one or two co-curricular. They cannot become master of all, right? Once a child knows what their skill set is, I think anyways you have to invest that extra time as a parent for your child. So if your child is a good tennis player, just wo school mein tennis court mein khelne se wo bada acha player to banega nahi. You'll have to put that extra effort after school. Likewise, if it is for swimming, or if it is a dancing, or if it is instrument playing or whatever. So getting that minimal exposure at school is okay for them to know what is their interest. But if there is an interest, then you as a parent will have to push your child after school hours, right? So for me, having all that shosha na school mein, jahan pe wo sab ghoda gaadi bhi ho raha hai, archery bhi ho raha hai, that is not very important for me. Okay. For me, more learning how the teachers are, overall how the school shapes your child. I think these things matter more than a big, big infrastructure and not too much focus on the learning
aspect.
I think my take on this is, yes, of course, I would say infrastructure as in, shosha to obviously even I don't like. But of course, infrastructure mein aap the bahut aur cheeze bhi I feel aati hain. I think there should be a good open space for a child right now, which I think there are so many schools which are missing on playgrounds, as if I think. Our kids are so confined to spaces, like chote spaces. Unko lagta hai ghar pe raho, TV dekho. Matlab digitally, our kids are more, they are in dependency on digital, virtual bahut zyada ho gaya. So for me, I think open spaces, there should be grounds at least. Usme infrastructure mein mujhe, infrastructure mein I feel this should be a topmost priority for a parent right now, because
I agree. वो तो होना ही है, उतना तो होना ही चाहिए,
उतना चाहिए कि हाँ अभी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में अगर यार एसी नहीं है, आई एम फाइन विद इट, मुझे नहीं फर्क पड़ता मेरा बच्चा गर्मी में पढ़ पड़ रहा है, मेरा बच्चा सर्दी में पड़ रहा है, मुझे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है. बट हाँ, ओपन स्पेस, यू नो, इफ माई चाइल्ड डज नॉट डू वेल इन एकेडमिक्स और लर्निंग, एटलीस्ट दे हैव अ ऑप्शन. इफ आई एम सेइंग, आई एम जस्ट अ हाइपोथेटिकल सिचुएशन, आई एम सेइंग इफ ही इज नॉट इन टू एकेडमिक्स, एटलीस्ट देर इज समथिंग अदर देन दैट विच ही कैन एक्सेल इन टू, एंड दैट स्टार्ट विथ यू नो जीरो ग्राउंड, दैट इज द स्कूलिंग. Obviously, I am going to imbibe those things later on when they come to the school, come home, and I'm gonna inculcate all those things. But I would say that, you know, if he is into you know sports, so at least that thing should be there. So itna open space I really feel.
Even the studios, you know, I mean, you know, there is
Yeah.
an art room to express, and you know, where you can just kind of paint and you know, explore,
See, that's what I said,
Yeah.
Kupu, that there should
Yeah.
be that much
should actually aid the learning, right? When the
Yeah,
learning
hello. That is true.
facilities are going hand in hand,
Yeah, that should.
that is when the
Yeah,
right
yeah,
balance
yeah.
in the blend.
Academics should be there, as well as extracurricular should also be focused. I don't want ki my bachcha should be like, matlab like this is my own personal choice. Everybody has their own thing. My personal choice is like, if I know that my mera bachcha nahi achcha hai padhne mein, of course I will accept that. बट आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट अ स्कूल, अगर मेरा बच्चा अकेडमिक्स में नहीं अच्छा है, वॉट इज द अदर ऑप्शन आई हैव?
और फॉर दैट
या
मैटर
सो दैट,
एथलेटिक्स में अच्छा है, बट इवन स्पोर्ट्स में और भी
हाँ,
अच्छा,
इवन इफ
राइट?
और भी
इफ
अच्छा
वन
है,
कमिंग
या
इन
हाँ
एब्सोल्युटली,
एब्सोल्युटली. सो फॉर मी, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन दैट वे रियली मैटर्स, इन दैट वे, दिस वे इट रियली मैटर्स टू मी.
सो well now I think we just come down to the situation today. As of today, you know, the kids are some kids have restarted, some are going to start school in some time. Komal, as a mother, what are your expectations from the school now that the kids return back?
See, I think one thing this COVID has taught us all is to maintain गुड हाइजीन. यू नो, सो पहले कैसा होता था कि इवन इफ समबडी इज हैविंग अ कोल्ड, यू नो, द बच्चा को भेज देते थे क्लास में, यू
दैट
नो,
इज
जाओ
ट्रू.
जाओ, कुछ नहीं होता है, एंड देन बाकी बच्चों को भी कोल्ड हो जाता था, यू नो. एटलीस्ट आई थिंक नाउ एज पेरेंट्स, एवरी वन यू नो विल बी मोर मोर यू नो कॉन्शियस अबाउट दिस फैक्ट दैट इफ दे आर नॉट वेल, यू नो, दे विल नॉट सेंड देयर किड्स. एंड सेकेंडली, स्कूल ऑल्सो हैज टू टेक दैट एक्स्ट्रा इनिशिएटिव, यू नो, दैट इफ समबडी इज नॉट फीलिंग वेल, यू नो, प्लीज गिव आउट अलर्ट्स टू पेरेंट्स दैट प्लीज डोंट सेंड योर चाइल्ड इफ योर चाइल्ड इज नॉट फीलिंग वेल, एंड टेक ऑल द सेफ्टी प्रिकॉशंस इन स्कूल, मेंटेन हाइजीन, एंश्योर यू नो दैट द यू नो दे आर ऑल वेयरिंग देयर मास्क, सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग, यू नो, एंड जस्ट प्रैक्टिस ऑल द कोविड सेफ्टी हाइजीन थिंग.
Yeah, I agree with Komal totally. Like I as of now, I am not even thinking of I mean like taking this choice as of current situation. But of course, you know, if this is, I hopefully it is over, and it's like 80% also it's over. So I would really think that, you know, the schools are you know taking all the safety precautions, and all the protocols are being followed. Of course, कोविड, एज राइटली सेड बाय कोमल, कोविड ने सबको सिखा दिया ओरल हाइजीन, छोटे से लेके बड़े को उसने सबको सिखा दिया क्या आपको, यू हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ. तो माई 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 5 year old किड इज नाउ ऑल्सो टेलिंग मी, अच्छा वी आर गोइंग आउटसाइड, मामा वेयर इज योर मास्क, एंड अच्छा वेन यू आर गोइंग कमिंग इन द हाउस ऑल्सो लाइक, मामा वी हैव टू वॉश आवर हैंड्स. सो दे लाइक नाउ दे नो लाइक दीज थिंग्स. बट ऑफकोर्स दिस इज आवर हाउस, मतलब हम अपने घर में हैं, घर में अपने हम लोग को सब कुछ पता है क्या करना है. बट ऑब्वियसली व्हेन वी गो टू द स्कूल, वी आर नॉट आर आर वी डोंट हैव अ कैमरा ओवर देयर, वी आर नॉट वॉचिंग आर किड्स 24 लाइक वट एवर टाइम स्पैन दे आर स्पेंडिंग इन द स्कूल ऑफकोर्स. सो वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन देयर, सो आई वुड रियली ट्रस्ट द स्कूल, द you know, the school authorities to invite those things every single day. So I think
I think the school should maintain some sort of transparency also.
Some sort,
in the sense that if something ill, you know, they should communicate it to the, you know, to the parents, to the staff of the school, you know, because many a time they try and hide these things.
Yeah.
You know? Right.
Of course. I think a parent should. Yeah. I agree because sometimes schools do, you know, hide these things because of their own reputation. But I think for these things, I think school should also understand the lives are on stake. Hai na? So, ye to karna hi padega aapko. Ab post-COVID situation mein, agar mera bachcha, obviously, my trust is in your hand. Post-COVID situation mein, agar mera bachcha ja raha hai, I'm keeping my trust in your hand. Because you will do good with my child.
I think they should not send us these consent forms.
Yeah, that is absolutely true. I think they should not send, because I think it's
this is like, you know, we are not responsible for your for anything that happens to your child. That thing, you know,
how can totally
you sign to, as a parent?
Absolutely. I totally agree with Komal, because hame consent form bhejne ka kya fayda yaar. You see the situation yourself here. If you are saying consent for me, if you're saying that we are gonna, we are expecting 100% occupancy in the classes, so what are protocols are you taking for my child's safety? So I think those grounds, the school should have a transparency. If you are taking our consent, you also tell us, na, ki what are you guys, what safety protocols are you taking?
Absolutely.
You should write the full pura consent ke andar, they should be pointers accordingly from your side. Our hamare side se to ja raha hai sab kuch, but ab tumhare side se bhi kuch consent to hona chahiye na.
Exactly.
Great. Komal, any final thoughts on, you know, what you would want parents who are probably looking up to you to understand this new phase coming up? How can it be easier, better, smoother
in terms of the COVID times?
In terms of all the times to come, you know, the school journey is going to go on. I think this is one aspect, you know.
I think first thing is they should follow EduSto, you know, so that good input. Anna, that is the first step.
And
the first step should be that.
I think with this session, you know, what we're really aiming is, you know, very important point which both the mothers had mentioned earlier, that when we're actually looking at going to schools and understanding about them, we might understand what the school wants to tell us. However, to know what, you know, probably they're not telling us, or things that, you know, we would know only from personal experiences comes from parents. So definitely connecting mothers, parents together and having these discussions, I think this is very healthy. And Komal and Preeti, thank you so much for your time. And I think it was indeed very, very helpful for all our viewers. And Preeti, your final thoughts. Yeah.
No. I think first step should be, like, you should not be overwhelmed by this, you know, hamara bachcha kya karega, kahan jayega, kya hoga, kaise hoga. I think you should sit back, relax, follow EduSto. That is the thing, you should do it and leave everything to these people. They're going to take your child as their own child, and then they're going to, you know, apne bachche jaisa samajh ke hi ye log karenge. And I think more zyada ho gaya ye, but theek hai. But I think
my point is that, see, you both been there, right? That anxiety, I'm sure, came to you more than once. I'm sure that panic attacks, oh my god, what is going to happen, is this not fine? The point is, you've been there and now you're through that. So I think the funda is that all will be well, and, you know,
all will be happen. Well, of course.
The thing is, don't panic. There's no need to panic.
I think panic karne se bajaye,
you just need to be, you know, you just need to do your good research, see what fits you, you know, as a family, your parent, for, because every school's approach is different, you know. Do your research, talk to people, And then, you know, you make a decision, a well-informed decision. That's what I can say. There's no need to panic. Panic se kuch nahi hota hai, you know. It only increases your stress. So, yeah, so you just have to, you know, take a right call by doing good research. That's it, you know. If you have to go and do some legwork by visiting all the schools, also do that, you know.
And you see, also need to, you know,
every school mein ye hota hai, not happy, you know. So it's not like one fit formula for everybody. It's different for different people.
And moreover,
for me, maybe the school works, but for somebody else, it's not.
Absolutely.
So I think moreover, the child should be you know, comfortable in whatever school you are you know, opting out for him or her. I think that is more important for that. Like, आपको ये तो अपने अंदर तो पता ही है obviously कि हाँ, like panic attack से तो कुछ नहीं होने वाला, but I think इतना हम समझते हैं कि हाँ, हमारे बच्चे के लिए क्या अच्छा है क्या बुरा है, and that my child will be comfortable on, you know, thinking on his mindset also.
Right, right, absolutely.
Yeah.
Great. So thank you so much, both of you. It was a great session. And
same here.
I'm very, very sure that this did help you in your journey forward. So thank you. Signing off.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.